Welcome to the sawmill build. This is going to be part one of many. I don't know how many because I haven't filmed it all yet. We'll get to it. So this mill is going to be totally scratch built. No plans, just kind of go with the flow and see what mistakes we make along the way. It's going to be powered by a 420cc engine. It's going to be running 158-inch blade on rubber tires. These tires down here are actually the tires that should be up here, but we'll get to that in that video. Length of cut is going to be 12 feet, and the way the frame is built, it will be easy to extend if need be. Between the posts here, we have 30 inches, so probably 28 will be maximum width of cut, but that's going to be plenty for what I need to do. This has been a bucket list project of mine for a long time, and I'm finally going to pull the pin and do it, as we can see. So for this video, we're going to go over building this piece here. This is where the idler wheel end mounts, and she's a little stiff, it's been sitting there for a bit. This piece slides back and forth to adjust our blade tension. So if this is something you might have some interest in, give it a watch. Would help me out if you'd subscribe to the channel and see what else we have to come. If you subscribe, do me a favor, drop a comment down below saying I subscribed. Now let's get to building.
So today is going to be day one of many of the welding helmet hitting the ground. No, not well, probably. We're building a sawmill, people. This is 6 feet. Sorry for the wind. It's like a fucking hurricane here. 5x5x3/8. Half by six, 1x6. These four pieces are going to be a box. It's going to slide on this beam for the idler end. Got our plates all beveled up now. It's not a major bevel, but for what we're doing, it's going to be good enough. The grinder's kind of starting to make that smoke smell, so yeah. You don't want to push it too hard. So we got two pieces fitted up, sort of. We're going to tack them together, and then we're going to get some thin pieces of cardboard to shim the next two to give us a little bit of wiggle room. Two strips of Lucky Charms cereal box. We'll put them under the grill, it's windy as fuck. Everything we're going to weld is going to be with 3/3/2 rods. We'll attack the 6013 and restart so much easier. And do bulk of the welding with 7018s. Two will do for now. Cardboard here. That on there.
Slide that bean a little back a little bit.
There. Second piece of cardboard. The last plate. Got everything tacked together. And with any luck, that'll slide off of there without too much effort. If not, we'll have to cut some tacks and regroup, but whatever. We're going to switch from the 6013s it was tacked with, because they're easy to start, to 7018s, and we will weld this solid. We're going to jump around a lot, try and keep the heat evenly distributed. Yeah, so I'm going to put the camera back up and see how easy this comes off. We're going to keep welding it on the beam too, so to kind of
hopefully stop the distortion a bit. We'll see if it works, I don't know.
All right, moment of truth. Does it move? Not that easy. So far we've moved 3/4 of an inch. Another 1/4 inch. About 3 inches. Only 9 more to go. And we just broke some welds. In theory, it should slide right off. It does. Issue. Nice. A lot more wiggle room in one direction than the other, but minor.
Okay. So tacked together. We got a little wiggle, but that's not a problem. We need that. So now we're going to start. We also kind of mushroom the edges a little bit, trying to get it off. So we're going to start putting some weld to it. And this time we're going to be using some 70/18ths. We're using 60/13 for the tack up. I'm a no welder by any stretch of the imagination.
I can weld enough to figure it out. Why? That got something to do with the peeps. I guess we're done. Maybe we tripped the breaker, but that light should be on, because it's always on. So we come in here and open the door, it's dark. There's the motor for the sawmill. So we just lost power. Which isn't surprising, because it's been blowing like fucking crazy today. Today is Boxing Day, 2020. It is 13 degrees Celsius. It's at 54 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know. This is Canada. We don't do Fahrenheit. It's been an unseasonably warm fucking Christmas. But, yeah, I guess we're done. Because it's kind of hard to weld with no power. So we'll get some gear packed up and call it a day. Go for a little drive or something. We're back. We went and got some gas for the generator if need be. Like to eat. Went for a little drive. Still no power. They're saying power's gonna be back on at 5. It's like 10 to 4. Who knows? Because 2 years ago we lost power Christmas Day. And it was almost 3 days before we got back. So, let's hope that's not the case this time. At least it's a little warmer this year. But with this rain, I don't think we'll be doing much more welding today anyways, even if we do get power. So, yeah, I don't know. It'll be a lazy day, I think. Well, lazy night. We'll see what the day, night, whatever it is, brings. But, yeah, we're back. So I guess we're going to pick up where we left off, so to speak, after we clean up some snow. Power came back on last night, and out again, and on again, and out again, and on again. Rained like crazy, and then this shit came down. But that's okay. We will make do. That's part of winter. That's kind of cold. A lot colder today than it was yesterday too. So we're gonna get some gear drug back outside and pick up where we left off.
Time to weld.
So we got one pass all the way around. It ain't pretty by any stretch of the imagination. But we still got a lot to go. This is definitely going to be more than a one pass job. I'd like to have a wire wheel for the grinder, but I don't. So we'll do what we can. I don't think I'll bore you with the rest of the welding on this one. I'll probably time lapse what I did. So yeah, we're gonna let this cool for a bit, and then we're gonna pick back up with burning rods. Yay. Alright, so we're back briefly. I don't think I have enough rods here to finish this out today. And this doesn't look like it's focusing well. The chipping hammer does not do a good job of cleaning up the edges and whatnot. I took the grinder to it up here, but there's still a lot of shit in there. It's probably not the best for the weld. I just made a phone call, and Princess Auto is open today. It is the day after Boxing Day, but it is Sunday. So we're going to jump in the truck and go for a drive. Get some more welding rods and a wire wheel for the grinder. And we should probably look into a new grinder since we're there, because that one was having some pretty nasty smells come out of it yesterday. So it's only like 12 o'clock now, so we should be back here by 2 and have enough time to finish this today and maybe move on to the next step. We'll see though. So, we got the cheapest grinder they had, a wire brush. We'll get some gloves. So, we're gonna see how this goes.
Should make the welds lay in a little nicer.
Should have been doing that shit from the start. Oh well, too late now. We'll check back in once we're done with welding. There's no point watching me sit here and burn rod after rod after rod. Got a little too carried away, I think, putting the heat to it, because now it's getting real snug on the beam. I just had a hell of a time getting it back off. We're gonna let this cool off and see what happens. Maybe it'll true up a little bit once it cools. It's pretty warm right now. I've been taking my time, but not really at the same time. So, yeah, hopefully we didn't fuck that up. We've gone through a few rods. Wire brush on the grinder is making some difference though. The welds look so much better. I can get all the shit off of them. I definitely can't even touch that. I can feel the heat there. We're just gonna go chill out, let that chill off a bit and see what happens, I guess. Hopefully we didn't fuck it up.